Next month, an Army sergeant from New Mexico will become only the second living active duty soldier to receive the Medal of Honor for actions in Iraq or Afghanistan. Tonight, correspondent James Rosen tells this soldier's story.
3 years ago this May, in the mountains of Paktia province, 60 miles south of Kabul, the 75th Army Ranger Regiment conducted a daytime helicopter assault on a set of buildings occupied by a dozen terrorists. The Rangers easily cleared the outer structures, with then-Staff Sergeant Leroy Petry of Santa Fe, New Mexico, the senior non-commissioned officer on site.
He did not have to be there. He saw that they needed help, and he made a conscious decision to go in there.
Clearing the target building, Petry and Private First Class Lucas Robinson entered an outer courtyard area. That's when they came under enemy attack from two terrorists firing AK-47s. Petry was hit by a bullet that went through each of his legs. Robinson was also hit. They took cover behind a corner chicken coop, and Petry lobbed a grenade at the attackers. Another man, Sergeant Daniel Higgins, ran to join them.
You could hear the firefight, or the contact that was taking place with 2nd Platoon.
We exchanged gunfire with them several times. We threw multiple grenades trying to clear the back corner area. There really was no good way to do it without completely exposing ourselves.
Then one of the terrorists lobbed a grenade. Shot in both legs, Petry grabbed that grenade and threw it back, but it detonated as he let go and amputated his right hand on the spot.
Sergeant Petry called me personally on the radio and said, "Hey, my hand is gone." When I got to him, he was still giving, directions to guys, "Hey, you're make sure you do this." When they're putting dressings on his legs and telling guys, "Hey, go pull security. Don't just stand there."
During the battle, Specialist Christopher Gaither Cole of California died from a bullet wound to the head. All of the terrorists were killed by U.S. forces, and all of the American survivors credited Petry with saving their lives.
He did not consider the long-term repercussions. Without hesitation, he did what he could to neutralize that threat by grabbing it and throwing it away.
Now the proud user of a prosthetic right hand, Sergeant First Class Leroy Petry remains in the Army and will receive the Medal of Honor on July 12th, only the second living recipient from the Iraq and Afghan theaters. In Washington, James Rosen, Fox News.